Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be studying the introduction to 4G and we'll see what all ingredients together form the 4G technology. Remember, we have seen earlier technologies like 1G, 2G and so on. 4G is an enhanced version of all the technologies. Coming to the generations, or talking about the various generations of the mobile communication, generation basically means changing certain parameters or services in that generation. So here in 4G technology, what are the generation parameters that we are trying to change? Of course, higher bit rate. So peak data rates are required in this technology. Other parameter that we want to enhance or increase is wider channels. Because the data information is extremely high, hence wider channels are required. Also, the frequency bands has to enhance. We require higher frequency bands. Hence, in GSM, if you remember, the frequency band was in the range of 900 MHz, whereas for IMT 2000, that is the third generation, the frequency band went up to 2000 MHz. Similarly, in 4G, extreme high frequency bands are required. The other parameter that we want to change is high capacity. We want many users to be able to access the data and use at high data applications. Hence, higher capacity is required. Spectrum efficiency should be utilized. We remember we have spectrum which is very bandwidth limited. Hence, we have to multiple access the spectrum. Many users have to simultaneously use that spectrum. Hence, it is important that the spectrum efficiency should be utilized. Hence, higher spectrum efficiency in terms of bits per second per hertz per site is calculated. Next, we come to the ingredients of this 4G system. OFDM here is considered to be the most appropriate technologies for transmission. Remember, OFDM stands for Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiplexing. This technique is also used as a modulation technique, where we have multiple carriers that transmit the data. 4G is here considered to be one of the very important technologies of transmission as well as modulation. The other ingredients that together form the 4G technology are the MIMO technology. Remember, MIMO stands for multiple input, multiple output antennas that we have seen for transmission as well as for reception. Other technology is SDR, that stands for software defined radio. Radio resource management is one more technology. Mobile IP and relaying techniques, all these techniques together form the basic ingredients of the 4G technology. Let us see all these techniques one by one and let us understand what they mean. So first, let us come to the MIMO technology. MIMO stands for multiple input, multiple output. Means at the transmitter and the receiver, we have multiple antennas which transmit the information. MIMO is considered as an important technology for mitigating the negative effects of the transmission that were happening in the single antenna used. So MIMO here is helping us to provide extremely high data rates, better link quality, that is better channel quality, and it is also not consuming extremely high transmitter power. It is also giving us higher data rates or bit rates because we are using multiple antennas together over here. So use of this MIMO technology at the receiver and the transmitter is providing various other benefits like diversity gain, multiplexing gain, antenna gain, and it is also reducing the interference that is possible due to multiple users that are simultaneously transmitting in the nearby region. Let us come to the next ingredient, that is a radio resource management. Since we all know that the spectrum is very limited and we have to pay extremely high cost to acquire the access to that spectrum. Hence, it is important that multiple users should be able to access the spectrum. The main work of the radio resource management system is to help multiple users access the system. Radio resource management provides us with all the basic needs that are required for a communication to occur. The efficiency of this spectrum can be calculated, and it is calculated in terms of the number of channels that have been available or the number of users that are able to trying to access the system and are successfully gaining the access to the system. The next ingredient is a software-defined radio. The software-defined radio is forming a basic bridge between the softwares that are available and the hardwares that are being implemented. Now let us see what is the meaning of the hardware being implemented. In all the transmitters as well as receivers, we have basic hardwares like mixers, amplifiers, demodulators, modulators and so on. Filters are also important hardware. So because of this hardware, what we are able to do is we are able to transmit the information. That is, we are able to form a waveform over here. But this hardware makes the system extremely heavy. Hence, to reduce this impact of the hardwares that are available, what we are trying to do is we are trying to implement the same system using the software. Hence, it is called as software-defined radio. Radio means nothing but the channels that are available for the transmission. So, software here is defining the radio in spite of the hardware that the earlier systems had. The other disadvantage of the using of hardware is it creates an industrial waste of a very huge amount. Since we are using hardware for every single block of element, like for example, I mentioned earlier, that is modulators, demodulators, filters, mixers, oscillators, and so on. So in software defined radio, what is basically done is we are writing the software in terms of certain languages like C language or C++ language, and these languages are easily implemented on digital processors. Digital signal processors are those processors which are able to process the signals that are going to be transmitted. The next ingredient that form the 4G technology is the mobile IP. Mobile IP is nothing but the mobile internet protocol. This is basically an IETF, which is Internet Engineering Task Force. This is basically IETF, that is Internet Engineering Task Force standard. Now, why is this mobile IP used? This is used because as a user is mobile and is free to move from one place to another, this mobile IP helps the user to get the information irrespective of the location he is present in. So, if the user is moving from one location to another location, the datagram or the data packets that are available for the transmission of the user are easily be transmitted depending on the home location of the user. As we have studied in GSM, we have HLR, which tells the home location of the user, which is then internally routed to the VLR, which is the visitor location of the user. Similarly, here, mobile IP, irrespective of the location, is helping us to provide or to maintain the same IP address irrespective of the location of the user. The last ingredient that we'll be talking about in the 4G communication systems is nothing but the relaying network. So this relaying network are a broad class of network which relay the information from the source to the destination with intermediate nodes in between them. So, these intermediate nodes help in the transmission or the relay of information. Why do we require the relaying of information? For example, say the source or the transmitter and the receiver are extremely at far distance apart. Hence, the information is not able to reach the other point. Say the transmitter and the receiver are very far apart and the range of this transmitter or receiver is not able to reach the other end. Hence, what we require is we require intermediate nodes in between them so that the range of the transmitter is able to reach the first node or the first device, you can say. Then the information is relayed to the next node, and in similar fashion, the information is reached to the end point. For example, consider two devices that need to transmit the information. Say one is server and other is computer. Now, the distance between the server and computer is extremely large. Hence, to transmit the information, we require intermediate devices which will act as node, and the information from the server will first reach the first node, then the information gets relayed to the multiple next nodes, and finally it reaches down to the computer. This is nothing but an example of an internet service in which a relaying of the information takes place, since the distances among the transmitters and the receivers are extremely large. So, relaying is an important parameter or an important ingredient of the 4G systems. So, these were all the ingredients or the parameters of the 4G systems. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida and subscribe to eKida.